this is a total disaster. What am I going to do?
Hi, Hubert, are you okay?
Look at my violin, it's totally falling apart.
Oh, no.
Look at it. What am I going to do, Olaf? Can you help me, please?
Yes, it's this terrible humidity. It really does so much damage to your instrument. Yes, it's definitely something I can fix, but it's going to take some work. Okay, and next time you have to keep your instrument dry.
Thank you for helping me, Olaf. I know the instrument is in good hands and you're going to make it better.
Hi guys, and welcome to another episode of Ask Olaf the Violin Maker. Today I'm going to do a special show on humidity because here in Australia, especially on the eastern side, it's been raining non-stop.
It has been lashed by life-threatening flash floods in what's been described as a once-in-a-generation weather system.
Now, Australia's a huge continent, so it's just been the southeastern part of Australia where it's been raining a lot, but it really has been raining a lot. And that amount of rain, especially here in the subtropics or tropics, can cause some real problems for your instrument. Violins, violas, cellos, double basses, and guitars, and any timber instruments really don't like high humidity. And when we have like these low systems or trough systems that are coming through in some Asian areas, that would be like the monsoonal kind of rain. When we have those kinds of systems coming through, the humidity in the air is just stagnant. It's like, you know, it is close to 100% humidity. It is constantly raining. It's a bit warmer. And this kind of climate is terrible for stringed instruments. And there's a few things that will happen. And firstly, the glue that's used to glue glue instruments, like it's a very old type of glue. They've actually used it in ancient Egypt. They used it in the 15th, 16th, 1700s to glue instruments. And it is actually a very strong glue. But if it's soaked for a while, that glue can actually be reversed. And what happens when you have that amount of humidity, it's like soaking the glue. So the glue can actually come apart. So that's the first problem that can happen. The second problem is that the timber gets saturated with water. So it's just the water out of the humidity out of the air actually soaks into the timber and gets captured there, and it makes the timber soft. Now, obviously, when you have that amount of tension on an instrument, the soft timber can actually warp and change shape. So here I've got about a 250-year-old German instrument, and it's got a very high arching. And one of the things that has happened to this instrument already is that the whole neck, which normally sits where it is now, has actually just dropped down, and right now it's dropped down so low that that the strings are a long way off the fingerboard. I'm going to show you on a different instrument. So here's an instrument with where the neck is actually out, so I can just show you what happens. So what happens is that after a while, like with that amount of humidity, the neck basically tips forward. Can you see that? Now, when the neck tips forward, the fingerboard comes down. And when the fingerboard is down, the strings stay the same height, but the fingerboards come down. So the strings are a long way off. And you can actually see that on this instrument. So that's one of the worst things that can happen if an instrument is subjected to an extreme amount of humidity for a long period of time. Some of the other things that can happen is that generally the bridge can warp because it absorbs humidity. The joints can come apart. So just anywhere in here, down there, the actual joints can come apart. I'll show you on a different instrument, one that's been by the beach and it's been really badly affected by this humidity. So here's an instrument that's had some really severe issues with humidity. And here you can see the actual ribs have come off the body. That's how badly the instrument has been affected by humidity. So the ribs, you can see them here, they're actually coming off, and that's absolutely dreadful. This instrument, you can see it has another problem. Can you just see here and back here and here as well how the timbre is darker? This is actually a problem caused by humidity and by playing in the heat. So what's happened over the years, the player has played in the Australian climate or a hot climate, they've been really sweaty, and as they were sweaty they were playing and they were touching this area, and the sweat kind of got onto the area, and that's not a problem, you can wipe it off. But after a while, varnish can wear off, and then if you don't do anything and don't wipe it down, the perspiration literally soaks into the timber and leaves oil, like the timber quite oily. And when that happens, the timber literally won't glue together properly anymore, and it becomes a really big problem for a violin maker, because I have to try and soak that oil out of the timber, and that's almost impossible. And I have a few clients that have this problem, and it's really, you know, they, whenever it's really humid, they always have problems with their instruments, even though we've done a lot of work on the instrument. And in those cases, sometimes, you know, you literally have to replace whole parts of the instrument to solve the problem. So it's absolutely disastrous when this kind of thing happens, you know, it's terrible. So what do you do to get around this? Like, how do you keep your instrument dry? So when you have this kind of humidity, keep your instrument in the case and try and keep the case in your wardrobe with your clothes, because your clothes absorb some of the humidity. Next, so keep your house or the room that you can keep your instrument in closed, so it doesn't, you know, you don't want to open windows. When you practice, take out the instrument, play it, try and play it in a dry room, and then wipe it down and immediately put it away. And when you put it away, maybe keep something like a silicone satchel inside the case. You know the little silicone satchels? I'll show you. So they look like this, little silica satchel. So if you get a whole bunch of these, or you can get really big ones that can keep the inside of the case dry. If you don't have one of those, you can always get something like a pillowcase or a piece of material or something, and just iron it until it's totally dry, and then let it cool down and put it inside the case, and it will actually absorb the humidity. Some other problems that can occur when in humidity is things like old cracks can open up, joints can come open, the varnish can be affected, the whole instrument can warp, the fingerboard can fall off, the whole neck can fall out, neck grafts and things like that can come apart. So if you open up your instrument and you can see there's some problems, there are some things that you can do. The first thing I would do is I would take the tension off the strings. Don't take them down all the way, but take, you know, detune the instrument by at least 3 tones. And that way you've got a lot less pressure on the bridge and a lot less pressure on the neck. So that's the very first thing I'd do. Make sure you can get the instrument dry and get it to a violin maker. So it is absolutely crucial that you keep your instrument dry, because some of those repairs are literally thousands of dollars to deal with, and it's not worth it. So anyway, to summarize, make sure you keep your instrument dry, keep the instrument in the case if you're not using it, and make sure you keep the case dry somehow by putting something dry in there. And when you're practicing, make sure you practice in a dry room. And as soon as you finish, put the instrument back in the case. Anyway, I just had to do this because of the incredible amount of rain we've been having here and in Sydney. And so I just really wanted to do this video to help you guys out. Anyway, keep dry and keep making beautiful music. Remember to like and subscribe and hit the little bell. And I hope this helps, and I hope you never have this kind of problem with your instrument. All right, see you guys.